Hi, I'm Abby Davis, and this is my lesson. Since it's December, we start with holiday traditions, and the best way to start with that, with the kids, is to have them decorate. They're all excited about it anyway. This one isn't very hard to get people sucked into. They like it. And we have a curriculum that allows me to put things on the board. We read the story together, page by page. It has different levels. So depending on who I have in class and who I want to read, I can choose different levels, and I can show you some of the pages. Some of the pages are like this. Some of the pages are like this. For some of the kids, it's easier to have the pictures with the words. It helps them to be able to read and to understand what we're saying and what we're doing. This brief lesson is just the start of the tradition and unit. Sorry, I lost my words. The tradition unit. Oh, I lost this. And what we did, we go through the tradition preview, then we go into different chapters and talk about different traditions. It's not just Christmas, even though for the group that I have right now, Christmas is probably the only one that they know about. They hear about some different traditions from other cultures, but we're in a small town and it's not a hugely diverse group, so they're all doing the same thing. So we go through the story, and then we have questions that go with it.
Good morning.
Because they have color, and the ones that I print are only black and white. So color seems to draw people in as well. It gets their attention, makes them more engaged. You see the pictures on the board. Once we've gone over the story, usually two or three times, and discussed it thoroughly, then we go to the questions, which I was trying to show you earlier. And the questions are also very diverse. You have the short little rectangular squares there. Those are for words. They can either write the answer in, or they can use word cards and just paste it in or tape it in. It just depends on what the kid can do. Then there's bigger ones for the picture cards. Bigger squares, bigger answers, pictures and words. Then, if the kid really needs to narrow it down, we have one question per page, and it already has the squares put in, and we use those squares. Some of the questions will have three squares, and it'll have three different answers in it, like a multiple choice, but it's one question per page, and it's horizontal like this, so that the kids can look at it. It makes it much easier. It's already differentiated for the students. They like it, and I allow them to choose, for the most part, which ones they want to do. It depends on the day. Sometimes this one's easier with no pictures, but sometimes they prefer the pictures. Sometimes we do these on the board, because I can project it up there, and they can use the pen, and they can circle the answers, and then we can print it right then, and then it's all done. They like that too. Here's the one that has the three already. Then, just because, you know, you have to keep ready for test prep, they have at the back, the last questions usually have circles. This is great for kids who can write or hold a pencil. It's a little more difficult for those who can't. So again, we go back to these. If you can't hold a pencil and you can't circle it, we might have to use this. It just depends on who the person is and what their needs are. We have comprehension questions. You have inference questions. We do a lot of main idea with this. It's all built in. It's all built into the discussion. In the lesson plans themselves that come with this, it has a lot of discussion questions in it. There's pages and pages of the discussions and how to guide that, and extra activities. So one of our extra activities was to do stockings. So yesterday, because that's pretty much a tradition that all of us had, we made stockings. And if you look over here, you'll see, don't get too close to them, but you can see that they've already decorated them yesterday with glitter. It's really cool. And they had a good time, and it gave them a chance to talk about tradition, because that's kind of an abstract concept and was kind of hard for them to understand what tradition is. It's something you do over and over and over in the family at the same time of year, or in your group, at your church, at your community, at your school. What do? We all have different traditions. And what ones do we share?